Hey guys,
my name is Kuyanche and welcome to episode 13 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So as you recall, last episode we talked about how you were able to automate the production of Buildcraft chipsets. In this episode I will be talking about several methods on how to automatically fill buckets and bottles with water. So let's get started. Even though something like this seems rather straightforward, I had a couple of people suggesting me something like this, so I thought, why not actually show you guys. So like always, I got myself a logistics power junction to provide the power necessary to actually power these logistics pipes, and in this case a logistics RF power provider, because to actually fill the buckets I am using an autonomous activator, which uses some RF. If you have any other methods that can fill buckets, of course this will work, but this is just one of the many methods out there that will use this. So, set to this autonomous activator, I got myself a logistics chassis pipe Mark II, set with two crafting modules, one being the bucket will give you a water bucket, and a glass bottle will give you a water bottle. And then, hooked up to that, I got myself a crafting logistics pipes and a logistic crafting table, pretty much set to make the water stone that I also talked about in a couple of episodes earlier, because it doesn't actually use up the water bucket. And this time I decided to use a different upgrade that you can set, which is the crafting byproduct extraction upgrade, pretty much meaning that you will be able to extract byproducts from a crafting pipe. Pretty cool. So this recipe doesn't use up the bucket, but it does use up the water, so that is why I have this recipe set up like so. Then of course on the other side I got myself a logistics chassis pipe Mark II, like always, with a provider module and some polymorphic item sink module in it, just to pretty much act as the storage of this network, and a request logistics pipe right here hooked up to a chest so I can actually request these stuff. Underneath here I also set up a basic pipe to pretty much act as the default route, but that's not really necessary. So let's quickly see what happens when I try to request, for example, 8 of this water stone. It will take out the 8 stone and a bucket. The bucket will be sent into the autonomous activator. The autonomous activator will right click, take the water out, and this logistics chassis pipe will know that it is pretty much done with the recipe. It will take the bucket out, send it over to the crafting table, craft the water stone. The water stone will be taken out, and thanks to the byproduct upgrade, it will also take the bucket out. The bucket will be sent to the default route, in this case back to the chest, and the request is successfully fulfilled. Pretty awesome! It's pretty straightforward, but like always, if you guys want to know something, even if it's kind of straightforward, feel free to let me know and I will make a video of it. So again, let's quickly see how it works with a bigger request. Just as easy as that. Works just as easy as you would expect, works fluently, and of course I can also request something like water buckets if I were, or water bottles, like I want 16 of, I need to request the proper one, of course, the filled with water ones, otherwise it's really useless. So as you can see, this thing is right clicking one at a time, and it will successfully do this request. Pretty cool. So yeah, this can be used for a lot of things, including possibly brewing automation, like the water bottles, other recipes that require water, water buckets, all kinds of cool stuff. And with that guys, I will be wrapping up this episode. Like always, I hope you found it very useful, educational, and also entertaining. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.